Let us discuss the experimental verification of Ohm's law. And by Ohm's law, we know well that the current and a resistance can be directly given as V by R. And just to verify this experimentally, let's have a look on the circuit diagram which we can see here in the figure. You can see there is a resistance connected with an ammeter to measure the current, and a potential difference across it can be measured via voltmeter. Now in this situation, we can change the battery potential difference and we can measure the current and voltage across the resistance and plot a graph. And here in this situation, if we keep the resistance at a specific value R1, and you can see if the voltage is increased from say a given value of V1 to V2, here you can see the current in the circuit will also increase. The voltage we can measure from this voltmeter and current we can measure from the ammeter. And if we plot a graph in this situation, we can see if along with voltage we plot a graph of current. Experimentally, I cannot show you by making it in a table, but here I can say if in your physics lab you will do the experiment, such kind of a graph you will get. In this situation, the graph will look like this situation. It will be a straight line. We are varying it from a voltage V1 to V2, or even if you increase the voltage from 0 to a specific value, current will increase from I1 to I2. And in this situation, you can see here the value of a slope of this straight line, 10 theta, will get as I by V, which can be written as 1 by R. So in this situation, we can say the slope of the curve IV, we can simply write as the reciprocal of the resistance used in the circuit. And as it is coming as a straight line, experimentally if we calculate it and we measure the value of R using this as a reciprocal of slope of IV curve, which is plotted in the experiment, you will find that this experimental value of resistance will almost or exactly match with the resistance you are using in the experiment. Another thing you can also execute by changing the resistance, say if you increase the resistance to a value R2, then we can say if we again plot a graph, the slope of this straight line will decrease. If this is plotted for resistance R1, for a higher resistance R2, the slope will be less. This is theta 2. We can say as resistances increase, the slope is going to decrease. So always remember that on increasing resistance, the slope decreases. This resistance here we are manually increasing because we have used a variable resistance. But if you change the temperature of resistance, then also we can say for the same resistance, if a graph is plotted at a temperature T1, then at a higher temperature T2, its slope will be less if T2 is more than T1, because we know at higher temperature the resistance is more than the initial resistance. So similar graphs you are going to get if you are increasing the resistance manually or you are increasing the resistance by change in temperature. So this is the experimental verification of Ohm's law, which you can also manually perform the experiment and verify in your lab.